Alhamdulillah pemirsa, it's amazing knowing that Syekh Abdul Bari asalnya adalah dari Vietnam. Kemudian beliau menetap lama tinggal di Amerika, kemudian melanjutkan studi di Madinah, ya University, dan alhamdulillah beliau kemudian menjadi juru dakwah di Amerika, Eropa, Kanada, dan kemudian masuk ke Asia, dan sekarang ini masuk ke Indonesia lewat Jakarta. Alhamdulillah. Tadi beliau sudah menjelaskan tentang bagaimana mengikuti Rasulullah Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, mencintai Rasulullah Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. Okay, Syekh Abdul Bari, how we do follow Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi? Can you explain for us?
Yes. To follow the Messenger of Allah Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam is something that is very important in our time right now, because we Muslims, we have to show the non-Muslims the example of how a true Muslim should be. And of course, the best example is the example of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam.
Uswatun hasanah.
Yes, uswatun hasanah. Mm-hmm. And unfortunately, a lot of Muslims now, they don't follow the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, or they delay in following him. Sometimes they say, oh, tomorrow, maybe next week, maybe after I get married. But that's not how the companions of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam were. And the companions, when they would hear something from the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, they would follow right away.
Immediately.
Yes, immediately, without delay. Like, sami'na wa ata'na. We hear and we obey.
Here, yes. In Indonesia, sami'na wa analisa. Not sami'na wa ata'na.
Yes, it's not only Indonesia.
Sami'na and check it. Yeah. Check it first. We see what is it, blah,
yes,
blah, blah.
Yes, yes. It's not only Indonesia. It's everybody, oh. Everywhere in the world right now. The Muslims in America, in Canada, in Europe, in many other places, is the same type of thing. Mm-hmm. That's the problem we have now. Mm-hmm. The companions, they used to follow. When they would hear, they would follow. When they knew it was prohibited, haram, they would leave it right away. Just like when the prohibition of alcohol, mm-hmm. before it was permissible. Then when it was haram, when some of them were drinking,
directly
they would
leave
directly
it,
throw it away. They didn't say, okay, let me finish this. No, not only that, but they smash the containers.
Let me 50, yeah?
Yes, no, the 50 until I retire, until I graduate, until after school, or, you know, university, all the time.
Thank you.
But if we want Allah to respond to us when we ask, Ya Allah, we have to respond to Allah first.
Oh, mashallah.
We have to respond to Allah first, and that's why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He says, يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا اسْتَجِيبُوا لِلَّهِ وَلِلْرَسُولِ إِذَا دَعَاكُمْ لِمَا يُحْيِيكُمْ O you who believe, give your response to Allah and His Messenger when they call you to that which gives you life.
Kau lihat, azan manggil aja kita masih asik kerja, rapat, dagang. Ya kan Allah udah manggil, kita masih ada di warung kita, masih ada di sekolah. Nuntut ilmu sih nuntut ilmu, tapi S2 sholatnya jam 5. Masa S2 sholatnya jam 5? Kenapa S2 sholatnya jam 5? Karena kelasnya itu kelas sore. Okay, continue.
Yes. During the time of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, their instinct was to follow immediately. If there's a prohibition, to leave it immediately. One time, Abdullah ibn Rawaha, in Jumu'ah, he was coming to the masjid. And outside, he was still outside the masjid. Hmm. The Messenger of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam saw people were standing up in the back of the masjid. Hmm. So he told them, Ijlisu, everybody sit down. And Abdullah ibn Rawaha, hearing that command from the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he was outside the masjid, but he sat down, even in the sun. Because for them, it was instinctive, immediate following. They were afraid to go against
there
the orders.
There is feeling
of the
to love Rasulullah. Eh?
Yes, because they love, when they hear his voice, immediately they follow.
Allah.
That's how the companions were. But that's the big problem we have now.
Makanya kalau disebut itu Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, kita kan harus mengucapkan Allahumma shalli wa sallim barik. Itu yang paling dekat, yang paling kecil, karena kita harus langsung. Okay, close this segment with your nice statement.
Okay. Alhamdulillah, you know, in order for us Muslims to come back to the Quran and the Sunnah, the Quran and the Quran, we have it with us. The Sunnah, we have it also. And Islam is perfect. The problem we have is how we respond to the Quran and the Sunnah. And if we respond to it quickly, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will respond to us also. And that's why the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, "Ta'arraf ila Allahi fi ar-rakha, ya'rifka fi shidda." Know Allah in times of ease, and then He will know you in times of hardship.
Indah sekali pemirsa, tapi kita harus lihat dulu tayangan yang berikut ini. Tetap di Wisata Hati NTV bersama Yusuf Maso dan Syekh Abdul Bar.
In a world of darkness.
You have a good eye for slaves, Elijah.
I'll take him.
One man sought wisdom from God. What was revealed to him would change the world.
To hear a prophet of God.
It was a time when revelation challenged tradition. From an ancient desert comes the timeless story of rebirth. The story of men, angels, and a messenger of God.
There is no God but God.
And Muhammad is his prophet.
Be patient, because you have an appointment in paradise.